Hey guys, welcome to the Swapmoto Live Show presented by OGIO Powersports and FMF Racing. I'm Don Maeda and I'm joined today by a legend in our sport, Pete Fox. So second trip down, so thanks for coming in.
Yeah.
What absolutely. Do you think of our COVID-19 quarantine studio?
This is a good one. I mean, does everybody know that this is McGrath's spot?
Everybody that comes. We had Vince Friese on the other day, and I guess he's a big McGrath fan, and when we're on commercial break, he's like filming.
I mean, you guys don't ever turn the camera around and let everyone see this?
We've done it before.
It's pretty cool. Maybe I'll have to like shoot some video and post it or something.
Yeah, absolutely.
People would love seeing this.
So exciting time for you, Pete. What has it been, about 2 weeks now since you launched Renen?
Yeah.
And dude, I mean, I was on the mailing list and, you know, on edge, waiting to check it all out. And when I got the mailing with the newsletter, I went on the website and there was one pair of size 30 pants left. So it's obviously been very well received. So how does that feel?
So it's not a newsletter. You're kind of showing your age by calling it a newsletter. Email blast. Because it was our first launch go live, technically we had to let the website turn on before we sent the email blast out. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I guess super excited that some people were waiting and watching on that day. And shit, by the time we turned it on, there was a lot of stuff that was sold out.
Yeah.
Because people were so enthusiastic. It's really cool. It was a great launch, and the reaction to everything we're doing has been really positive.
Mm-hmm. I guess backing up a little bit, you know, you could have done anything. You didn't have to do anything. Why motocross gear?
Yeah, it's because I love the sport and I love making products. I love designing things. I've been, you know, doing it basically my entire life since I was a teenager, and I still love it as much today as I've always loved it. Mm-hmm. It feels like it's part of who I am, and I haven't lost that fire, that drive to try to make really cool stuff for this sport and this industry that I love so much. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Obviously, pant, jersey, glove right now. You hinted before that there's some collabs, boot helmet. Why choose pant, jersey, glove? Because that's what you know the best, instead of like all new helmet line or all new boot, hard part.
Because a big part of the pant, jersey is our ability to make it in the US, right? So we're making the pant and the jersey here in the US. We're doing it in a different way than anybody else has done so far.
Mm-hmm.
And we can make it, I think we can make fantastic product, and we can do it quickly, and we can change it up a lot.
Mm-hmm.
It's a totally different animal when you talk about hard parts, hard goods like helmets or boots.
Mm-hmm.
And there's people that are, there are people that are making really good product, and they're brands that I like and respect, and people that are doing it are people that I like and respect. And so for me, the opportunity to collab with some of the best boot, helmet, goggle companies and those people, it's something that, I 20 years ago, I never would have thought that this would be a possibility. And so it's really fun for me personally. I think people are going to be excited with what we're going to be bringing out.
Mm-hmm. I want to say that the reception has been great. You obviously sold out. What feedback have you gotten from friends, consumers, industry people about the look and feel of the gear?
Yeah, so the look initially, I've been intentionally keeping it really clean and simple. Mm-hmm. Because I that just feels right to me, and I want to focus a lot on the fit and the function of the product. There's more wild stuff that's coming. We're going to be doing releases essentially every month. And so, there'll be different flavors coming each time. just allowing me to be creative and doing what I, you know, something that I'm excited about creating. Mm-hmm. It's a great creative outlet for me. But the reaction's been really good. People are very excited and really supportive about us making it in the U.S. and trying to do something special. You know, the people that we've already gotten, people that bought, were able to buy some of that stuff, have already replied to us and told us, you know, how excited they are about mm-hmm. the quality and the look and the fabrics and things. So, so far it's great.
Cool. I was DMing with Ryder a little bit, mm-hmm. and I'm also, oh, you've been riding this stuff. How is it? And the thing he mentioned is he likes the liner in the pants.
Yeah.
So can you tell us what's different about that?
Yeah. So the way we did the lining on the pant, you know, it's kind of the way we're thinking about all of the products. Like, you know, instead of doing a giant line and doing our own hard goods and, you know, 100 different things, I want to be really focused and on those things that we're doing, do them really, really well. Mm-hmm. And think about every level of detail. And like, for example, the pant liner for most companies, including companies that I've created in the past, you know, the liner is something that was often overlooked. Or, you know, we didn't want to spend the money. And with Renen, we want to focus on all of those things. And so mm-hmm. we've come up with a different way to do the lining that for the average consumer, I think is going to be a big benefit and exciting. It feels great. I think it functions better. Mm-hmm.
Okay, the Made in the USA thing was, we did a video on launch day, and some of the comments in the video, a lot of it was like, wow, Made in the USA, that's awesome. Was it tough to keep your stuff priced competitively made in the USA as opposed to Asia?
It's definitely, that's a challenge, right? And that's one of the reasons why, as we're small and growing, you know, at this point, we have to do everything direct to consumer. Mm-hmm. For the two reasons is because our quantities are small, we're just starting out. And so, like, you know, I wanted to keep everything really simple. I don't know, at some point, I'd love to be able to open that up and have a broader network. Mm-hmm. But at this point, it's small. But we are able to, you know, I built the factory. This is a Renen factory. It's our own factory, in case anyone's wondering. So all of our design, all of our development, all the production, everything is happening under our own roof. So that allows us to mm-hmm. To be competitive on pricing.
Okay, you and I are here in not so sunny SoCal right now, but in having a conversation with Clayton Williams, who works with you, he says there's snow outside.
Yeah.
Where is your factory, or is that top secret?
It's, you know, I don't think I've announced it or anything. But, you know, anybody that's going to get a shipment is going to see on the label where it came from. So, you know, it's the factory is in Indiana, mm-hmm. in the middle of the country. And it's just outside of Indianapolis, the race capital of the world, and it's really close to the Ironman National track.
So oh, nice.
That's our local track.
Okay, cool. Hey, Pete, we're going to take a quick break here from our sponsors. We'll be back with more Pete Fox. Hey, welcome back to the Swapmoto Live Show presented by OGIO Powersports and FNF Racing. Once again, I'm here with Pete Fox. How did you choose Ryder DeFrancesco as your sole Renen athlete?
Yeah, I mean, that's where we are now. I'm super excited to be working with Ryder. I've known Ryder and his family for years now, working directly with them when I was with Fox, and then also when I was the last couple of years, I designed some stuff for Ryder, and just really like him, and just at this point, with us starting out, I think he's the right athlete because he's young, he's up and coming, one of the most exciting riders in the U.S. at the amateur level. And our focus right now is definitely grassroots and consumer. So it's a great fit. I'm really excited to be working with him. And we'll see where the team grows from there. We're also working with Ivan Tedesco. He's doing a lot of testing.
Yeah, I saw him. That was a new development since we talked first time, right?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. He's doing a lot of testing. He's also Ryder's riding coach, which it's a great connection. But I've known Ivan forever as well. Ivan's a great guy and a really good tester. And he's here, so close by. So that's one of the other great things is, I went out and we did some testing last week. We were going to test tomorrow, but it's, the weather's not, hasn't been that great. But I'm going to see him on probably Tuesday and we'll test again. Like, that's one of the great things about Renen. And, our ability to test and develop and make really quick changes, faster than anybody in the industry for sure.
What feedback did Ivan give you after he rode in the first time?
It was great. The thing that everybody loves is the jersey fabric, the jersey fit. The fabric feels great. It performs great. It wicks sweat. But then I think we really nailed the fit. It's not too slim, not too loose. It's a little more fitted in like through the arms and a little looser in the body. I think, which is like for the modern rider, it's like kind of right where we want to be.
Okay. I noticed when you were talking about, you referenced Fox.
Yeah.
And you kind of hesitated, like almost like it was bad to say it, but I mean, it's your last name after all, but when you talk to people that change teams or change companies or something, they're always like that a little bit, but Fox will always obviously play a huge role in your life.
Yeah.
Have a special place there. But what is the, what was your most recent creation at Fox? Because I know that you stepped back before you did the Renen thing, but when would you be able to say that's Pete Fox's influence right there?
Going backwards?
Yeah.
That's a good question. Because the size of the team and everything. I'd have to think about that for a while. Some of the things that I'm really proud of is like the Instinct boot and the previous model of the V3 helmet and all the helmets, not the new one, but the original V3. So it's been a few years since the product that's out now, other than legacy product like the Instinct boot, for the most part were done by other people.
Yeah. When you guys came out with the pilot helmet, the original helmet, I'm guessing that was 97, 98?
I'm not good
around
with dates.
Around that time, but was it ever stressful entering the helmet market, considering it's a product that has greater liability?
The increased liability and responsibility too, right? Because you've got that moral, ethical, like, hey, I want to make sure that we're making things that are protecting people adequately and performing well, and especially at the pro level. I mean, these guys are putting it all on the line, right? So that there was a lot of, that was really stressful. The helmet was one of the most stressful things we've ever done, for sure.
Yeah. Sometimes I kick myself for, become so jaded. I've been a motocross journalist for over 30 years now, and so much product goes through my hands and everything. It's like, why didn't I save that, right? But mm. like I had a pair of the original Instinct boots that were all black before they were released.
Yeah.
Warren Johnson had me riding them and give him some feedback and stuff to relay to you. But I'm like, now I'm like, why didn't I save those?
You know,
like,
right?
Where did they go?
Yeah, I feel that way all the time, especially lately, thinking about, like, I'd love to have that pair of Instinct. That was so important. And, you know, some of the early, my early Zebra Fox designs, some of my favorite Fox designs through the years. I wish I had more of that stuff.
How about the Chameleon boot?
I'm glad I don't miss that. You know, we have that at Fox, and part of the, you know, while I was, you know, I did a lot of collecting at Fox. Mm-hmm. And we have there at Fox, we've got a pretty good library of things. I don't have as many personally mm-hmm. as I wish I had. You know, that's my, one of my goals is to like try to get some of that, a few more of those things. I've got some really good stuff, but I wish I had more always.
Okay, I remember the first Fox helmet, the big thing was the venting.
Yeah.
And then I remember when you guys did the anatomical cut in the pants, you know, bent that way.
Mm-hmm.
That was like things that Fox led with that you created. What is the one innovation that you're the most proud of?
The one innovation I'm most proud of?
I thought the pants cut for the riding position was just like mind blowing, right?
Yeah, I mean, that's great. I think the venting, we really, brought venting to another level on the helmet. I think the Instinct boot is one of the best apparel products ever in the history of the sport, probably. There's some of the stuff now, like, you know, the ratchet fly cam on pants, mm-hmm. you know, we're using it on Renen. Everybody, you know, it's kind of the standard, right? I came up with that design like 30 years ago, and it's still, it's now the standard for motocross. That's the kind of thing that I feel really good about. Something that that functions really well and that, you know, still is here today.
Mm-hmm. What is, what's the typical week like for you? You know, like, are you up real late, up very early, designing, making phone calls, negotiating deals? I mean, what, you know, because I mean, I've said it to my guys, you know, like, I'm intimidated by Pete Fox because I've looked up to him for so long, right? But like, you're like a mysterious dude. Like, what is the week like for you, you know?
So one thing definitely about me is, you know, it's true of creative people or people that are really passionate about something, is I will... Once I start to feel, it's weird, it's like a feeling, I'll have some ideas. Maybe for a while you don't have an idea, and then an idea will hit me and grab me, and then I get super passionate about it, and I'll just work and work and work, mm-hmm. and time will go by and I don't even realize it, you know. And that's actually, I love that. That means that I'm doing something worthwhile mm-hmm. with my time. It's just flowing out of me, you know, especially with, in the last few months with Renen, you know, I'll be up at 2 or 3 in the morning, mm-hmm. and I'll have to like get myself to stop. Otherwise I'd stay up probably all night working, uh-huh. just creating, because it's just flowing, you know, and it's a weird feeling, but it's a good feeling actually. Mm-hmm. So I guess that's more what my week would be like. It'll be these like extreme stretches of creative output, mm-hmm. and then I'll feel like, oh, I gotta like do some, you know, kind of regular business stuff, and I'll mm-hmm. like I'll do like 3 or 4 or 5 of those things in a day, and then I'll like take a little bit of break, go to the gym, or like do something, clear my head, and then the creativity will flow, and like mm-hmm. It's hard to turn it off.
Obviously the creative process is your favorite thing about Renen, I'm sure.
Yeah.
What is your least favorite part?
Jeez, definitely the creative. I mean, that's since I started doing this at Fox, you know. I'm really lucky that, you know, my dad had created a business where I was able to, you know, have my creativity like plug in to the business. my least favorite. It's just anything to do with numbers and spreadsheets and like, oh my God, that stuff.
Yeah.
That feels like work.
Yeah. Where do you draw your largest source of inspiration from?
It's a funny one. You know, definitely the weirdest is grocery stores.
What?
Grocery stores, malls. Like, I don't know. I'm looking at the camera because maybe some other like creative designers will relate to this, but you know, if I have enough time, I'll go to the grocery store and just wander the aisles.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, I'll buy some stuff too, but I'll just wander the aisles and like look at the packaging and try to imagine like the creative process that brought this certain, you know, chip to market.
Yeah.
And I'll like analyze the package. How do I feel about it? Do I think it's working? Is that going to be success? And then I'll go to the mall and I'll just like wander around and like look at stuff. I'll look at women's shoes or women's handbags and just, mm-hmm. I don't know. I'll just like kind of get, I'll lose myself like,
really?
in stuff. Yeah.
I think, well, shoot, when we started Trans World Motocross, I remember Brad McDonald and I came and had a meeting with you guys and I was super intimidated and you're like, make it cool. You know, like, look at the surf stuff. And I remember you said that. Well, there's a guy on a dirt bike outside.
That's
but,
cool.
if you talked about other sports that you're influenced by, is surfing still one of them?
Not so much. I mean, definitely surf for all of us. My brothers and I was a big influence. Late 80s, 90s, and even in the, you know, the 2000s when Fox was involved with surf. But I wouldn't say so much now. I'm not looking at the surf market like I was. Creativity comes from anywhere. That's why the grocery store thing is just weird. You know, when I was young, my brother and I used to go to Tower Records. Anybody knows Tower Records? And I just, you know, kind of do the same thing. I would just like go through albums, like starting with the letter A and just like go through and like flip album covers and see which ones like caught my eye. Mm-hmm. And go to a museum, and I don't know, you never know. Sometimes you go to a museum and nothing will like inspire you, and sometimes it will, and sometimes a grocery store will inspire you. And I mean, I do love cars. I love looking at cars. Mm-hmm. Car design is really, I mean, it's really cool, especially because, you know, I really like, maybe that's the grocery store thing. My favorite thing is a design or a trying to come up with a creative solution that has some level of either is a functional element to mm-hmm. it too, right? Where it's not just a painting. I love paintings and music and movies, but also like thing that's interesting about a car is that you're trying to solve like either the way that the car feels when you sit in it or the, you know, aerodynamic challenge and, mm-hmm. you know, kind of blending science and art together. Maybe that's because I tend to be a creative art person, and then, you know, my dad for sure being a physicist and my brother, you know, I had that influence through my whole life of mm-hmm. like trying to like blend those two.
I'm never gonna look at a grocery store the same. Hey, we're gonna take one more quick break. We'll be back for one more segment with Pete.
Don't try to be the fastest on the track.
Be the fastest ever. Work harder than everyone else.
Because dedication is everything.
If they say your goals are crazy, be insane.
Be fast.
Be the crazy one.
Be unstoppable. One goal, one vision.
We put our heads together to both reimagine and lift the bar on what a modern motocross helmet should be. Opt for the highest level of modern technology and energy dispersion with the Fly Racing Formula helmet. designed for an elevated defense against a wider range of real-world impact scenarios. Globally engineered with the most advanced materials and technologies available. Outfit yourself with proven technology, lightweight performance, and elevated impact management with the Fly Racing Formula Helmet.
What's up, guys? It's Brock Tickle. I ride for the JGR Yoshimura Factory Suzuki Racing Team, and I'm stoked to be back at the races. Planning my comeback to racing was cool to see. I have a lot of support behind me to get me here. FXR stepped up and invested in me, and I'm stoked to be part of them. FXR honestly kind of blew me away. All the product is awesome. The pants fit me awesome. The best fitting pant I've ever worn, and everything's sublimated, and it looks good.
To put our adventures on hold. But now is the perfect time to prepare for their return. Amsoil has your back with fast, free shipping, and ordering has never been easier. Just look up your vehicle, select your product, add an oil change to your cart, and check out. Spend $50 on Amsoil products, and shipping is on us. Order now at amsoil.com.
Welcome back to the Swapmoto Live Show, presented by OGIO Powersports and FMF Racing, here with Pete Fox. Going back to the grocery store thing, what is the best designed food item that's caught your eye?
What's the best?
Like packaging or something that's inspired you?
That's a good question. Lately, I've been really people are going to be bored. Lately, I've been really fascinated by the yogurt section. And I go over there. I don't eat yogurt myself, but I buy yogurt either for my girlfriend or for my, you know, my kids, and like, you know, just trying to figure out which of these packages. Some of the packages are clear and they show what's inside. Some that don't, and some are glass. I'm trying to wrap my head around like exactly what I think if I was going to do yogurt, how I would do it.
Okay, good answer. all right, so we. Sold out January's drop.
Yeah.
Does February drop Feb 1, or is it like a 15?
No, it's gonna be middle of Feb, you know. I don't know if it's Feb 18th or something like that. We'll, you know, again, people, the best thing is to get on the email mailing list.
The
I would
newsletter.
Also I'd also advise people to sign up. We're trying to make sure it's clear, but you know, you can sign up for the email list. You can also, like, if you create an account, mm-hmm. a customer account, then you'll get free shipping, which is always nice, right? Mm-hmm. But we'll be emailing that information, and hopefully on the on social media, on Instagram, we'll be updating that a little bit. But probably around February 18th, mm-hmm. We'll be doing the second drop of the limited edition stuff. Hopefully, you know, in the next week or two, we're trying to restock like t-shirts, and hopefully we'll be, you know, be able to, those will just, once we get them, we'll do a restock of those. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that's one of the, for me, kind of the fun things with this brand is just being able to like, hey, we've got it, let's like put it out there, right? Mm-hmm. And so the seasonality, waiting for the season, and you know, that's going to come in 9 months. That's not
once
part of this reality that I'm like working in now.
Any hints on what drop 2 is going to look like?
one of the beauties of it is I haven't even decided. How crazy is that?
Yeah, you told me before you have like 10, 11, and 12 done, but not
yeah,
two.
I do. I've got like the one that's going to come around September, as long as the boot, I've got the boot and limited edition gear will like be part of a collection. Mm-hmm. And the same thing with like a goggle is going to be part of a collection. I've already got those figured out. But that's, I mean, one of the crazy, amazing things with what we're doing with Renen is like, I can make that decision kind of at the really late in the game. Mm-hmm.
Have you gone through any of the consumer or customer lists or email subscription lists and found competitors in there?
I've seen a few competitors in there. I've seen a few like ex, you know, Fox employees in there. We'd had a couple ex, you know, Fox rep bought some of the first drop, which uh-huh. is super cool, you know, that feels good.
But like current competitors, like keeping up on you, keeping tabs.
Yeah, there's definitely, I mean, I would.
Yeah.
I mean, I think you're kind of stupid not to.
Yeah.
Right? You should always know what your competition's doing, right? Mm-hmm. If you can.
Yeah. What's your thoughts on, like, I had Dylan Ferrandis on the show a while ago, and we were just talking, and I was like, hey, you're like one of the guys that's like always worn an outside chest protector, right?
Yeah.
And he's like, dude, our sport's super dangerous. Why wouldn't you wear as much as you possibly can, and why wouldn't you, as a top pro, set a good example for the kids, right?
Yeah.
What's your thought on safety equipment, like chest protectors, neck braces, wrist braces, all that stuff? I mean, you've obviously produced that stuff and designed that stuff in the past. What is your take on that? Like,
I mean, unfortunately, our sport is one of the most dangerous, right? And I think I'm glad that people are wearing more protection now than they were, what, you know, 10 years ago. Mm-hmm. You know, I think that people should wear as much protection as they can where they feel like that they can perform on the bike. I mean, if you're a weekend guy, you should probably wear a lot of protection because you got to go to work on Monday.
Yeah.
Definitely. You know, do your research and find like what the best performing and safety and fitting product that you that fits in your budget and get it, you know. Mm-hmm. If you look at like what Jet Lawrence or not Jet, I mean Jet had a bad crash and
Faulkner
had a bad a bunch of guys crashed this last weekend. And luckily, a lot of those guys are wearing under protectors, you know, mm-hmm. Or a lot of those crashes would be worse. So, I mean, my feeling is like everybody in the industry should be doing as much testing and research as we can to make this sport as safe as we possibly can. Because, mm-hmm. you know, unfortunately, I think right now the bikes are at such a high level that, you know, it's probably at its most dangerous.
Yeah.
That it's been in the last like 30 years or something, you know, because mm-hmm. the tracks and the bikes and what they're capable of versus what, you know, us humans are capable of.
Yeah. Is that something in the future plans for you, like a chest protector, something
or
like
a motorcycle? Like if I could like wave a magic wand, I would detune everything. You know, I detune the bikes and I detune the tracks. I'd make it safer and like, you know, it's hard to take that, you know, put that genie back in the bottle. Mm-hmm. Your question was about like
is there going to be a Renen under protector, say? Because I mean, you have worked with so many technical products, right?
Yeah.
Like the impact foam and stuff like that.
It definitely, if I have an idea, if I have an idea to make something, some hard goods product, I would either want to make it ourselves or work with somebody and, you know, do a collab. Mm-hmm. That's why, you know, when I looked around the industry at products I wanted to have collab with Renen, you know, they're what I consider to be, you know, at the highest level for performance and safety and function, mm-hmm. you know, because I just think that's really important. That's what I want to be associated and involved with.
Okay. We did a video on drop day, but explain to us the name again.
Renen. Yeah, so, you know, naming things is tough. You know, anybody that's named a child knows how much pressure that is, or named a brand, or... and so, you know, when I was looking around trying to think of something, I knew like kind of what, how many letters I wanted and what I wanted to not look like and what letters I didn't want to use. And I swear I must have been like thinking about it for a couple of years. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, I found a word that in German means racing. My dad, you know, I have such a strong relationship with my dad, and my connection with motocross and is through my dad and my family. And my dad to this day loves moto as much as he ever has. We talk mm-hmm. about the races like nonstop. We talk about the business. My dad like is cheerleading me, you know, he's super supportive of what I'm doing now. So to have that family connection to our German heritage and to racing is something that feels good. So I changed the spelling of a German word that means mm-hmm. racing.
Okay, Fox Racing obviously has an icon. There's the name and then the icon. Yeah. Are you working on a Renen like icon? Like,
I wouldn't say that I'm like consciously working on it. A lot of what I do creatively, I is subconscious. I really think that I really believe in the power of our subconscious. And so a lot of times I'll like sit and consciously think of it and something, and then I'll just let it like go into the back of my head and like leave it there for a while and see if it comes out later mm-hmm. in a dream, or like just sometimes this stuff just comes out. Right now I haven't wanted one. And I think it works great because, especially with the collabs that we're doing, those mm-hmm. companies have icons.
Yeah.
And so, you know, we can sit, you know, Renen with the brand, with the icon, and it's not like, it's not too much visual competition. It's mm-hmm. nice and simple. And everything I try to do is like simplify, find the best simple solution.
So you're telling me that in 10 years, we're not gonna see like people with a Renen icon tattoo on their body.
No, there might be an icon. I mean, I've thought from the beginning that at some point I'll go, okay, like I have this idea for this icon and I feel the need for it. Right now I don't feel the need for it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, one of the, it was in one of the movies, but the new wave Fox icon that you created, the slanted one,
mm-hmm.
I remember seeing, was it one of your brothers or you that got it tattooed?
My brother did, yeah.
Okay, sister. So then what do you think now when you see people with that tattooed on their body? There's a guy at our race series. He's a real muscular, older guy, but his whole body is these really nice, fine line black tattoos, black and white tattoos, black ink tattoos. And then on the back of his head, he's got a green fox head, like this big on the back of his head.
Yeah.
You know, but it's like, that guy loves your icon, your brand, what it means so much that he did that on the back of his.
Yeah, I mean that's the ultimate, I think, in what you can achieve with creating something is that another person will have that level of like personal connection to something that you made is amazing. You know, I have that. In some ways, like with Star Wars and with Apple Computer, and you know, I know a lot of people have that connection with like maybe a soda they drink, you know, where mm-hmm. like if you think about your life, your journey through life, and like things that have really meant something to you, you know, a lot of it is your relationship with other people, your family, your friends, and then there's, you know, I think we all have some connection to whether it's, you know, a movie or a food or a product. And to be able to have achieved that is like, it's really rewarding. It feels, mm-hmm. I always, as soon as that started to happen for us, when I started to see the, you know, what we were doing with Fox and how people were reacting to it, it made it feel a lot, I felt a lot of responsibility mm-hmm. to like, don't screw this up and try to make the best possible product, because like, you know, these people that feel that way about what you're doing, you don't want to let them down, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Man, I'm still waiting for the first Swapmoto Live tattoo. We had some Transworld tattoos. Nick Way, one time, was at a dealer signing, and he's like, whoa, 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 and he took a picture of this girl's arm and sent it to me. But super flattering, so I can imagine how it feels for you.
I mean, that's awesome, right?
Yeah. Well, hey, Pete, thanks for coming in. Best of luck. You don't need it, but best of luck with Renen. And
I'll take it.
I'm looking forward to getting in my first set.
I know. So. I need to find out where yours is.
All righty. Hey, guys, thanks for watching. Be sure to check out RenenUSA.com. Or is that the website?
That's RenenUSA.com is the website. Yeah. Or on Instagram. Yeah.
Okay.
RenenUSA.
Guys, thanks for watching. Like and subscribe to our channel. And we'll see you next week.
Thank you.